Kathryn Snearly moved to North Carolina to be a teacher. But over time, she began playing a different tune. About 10 years ago, she posted a video.
I wanted to get on YouTube and make this video about how to decorate on a dime.
It wasn't very slick, just for fun.
I don't feel like there's a lot of videos on YouTube that showcase how to decorate super cheap, but still make things look really classy.
You didn't think of this as a potential business?
Not at all.
They were focused on DIY.
So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a DIY version of this. That's
frugal living, as well as cleaning and organizing.
They're awesome for when you're putting away all of your decor.
Things she was good at.
Eventually, YouTube kicked in, and I remember getting my first $100 check from Google, being like, this is a thing. This can be a fun side job that I really, really enjoy. These big containers are just $1 or now $1.25.
Would you say the majority of your income is now from endorsements of products?
Yes.
And how do you choose which ones you want to do? Because I'm sure you don't do just anything.
No, and that's really important. What I've always said is, this is the story I'm telling, and if a brand wants to come alongside that and it's already a fit into what I was always going to say, perfect.
I picked up these Libman rags. They have these power scrub dots on them. I love them for my dishes, along with my Dawn power wash. Nothing in here is sponsored, just things that I really, really love.
It's led to real success. 1 million subscribers on YouTube has grown to nearly 2 million now, and more than 750,000 more on Facebook and Instagram. All there to learn how to keep their life organized.
Is this what you're looking for?
That is, and if that's as junky as it gets, you're doing really well.
Oh, well, thank you.
But don't you feel a little pressure that when people come over, they're going to judge how...
It's funny. I actually feel like it's the other way around. I feel like when I go places, people are like, are you judging my house that I have a judger? Yeah. I'm like, listen, no, I promise I'm not. Yeah.
What she is trying to do is subtly address the silent suffering.
2 years ago today, I lost my brother, Adam, to suicide.
My brother and I are very close. It's just him and I, and he really struggled with his mental health. So that was a challenge, obviously, for our family. There's a lot of mental health issues in my family, myself included.
It was enough to make Kathryn wonder if this is what she really needed to be doing.
And I was like, I have to pause making videos because I don't think I can. And it sort of got to the point where I was like, no. A lot of people have gone through something like this. Grief is pretty universal.
And she realized that she had more than just viewers. She was part of a community, one that helps her keep her life and mind well organized.
Click that subscribe button, join the Dime Tribe, because I would love to see you in the next video. I'm always grateful to have you here, and I'll catch you guys soon. Bye.
Bye, Buck.
Some people don't like it when I do this. They don't like it because they feel closed out. So maybe we'll just end with a hug. Does that work?
Fox 8 News. It's a good